Hello, myself Nimisha Goswami. Welcome in Warm Gear lecture. So, first of all, we will discuss about basic terminology which is used in warm gear. So, first of all, what is warm gear? So, warm and warm gear are used for transmission of power at very high velocity ratio between two not intersecting shafts. Okay, so here you can see that in this diagram, one element is, you can see here, is one element is like screw element and second one is right gear. So, first this type of gearing is known as warm gearing, and velocity ratio is very high in this respect. So, velocity ratio is 300:1, or it may be increased beyond this limit. So, this is consist of basically two elements, first a worm and second one is known as worm wheel or simply gear. So, here first element which is driving element is look like your screw portion, and this is known as worm. And another is driven member and which is your gear. And what is the material used for manufacturing of worm gear? So basically, generally worm is made of steel and worm gear is made of bronze or cast iron. So these are the material which is used in worm and worm gear. Now, so what is the basic terminology? First of all, axial pitch. So you can see here in this figure clearly, it is indicated by PA, and it is also known as linear pitch of worm. So how you will define? It is the distance measured axially, means parallel to your worm axis, okay, from a point on one thread to corresponding point on adjacent thread. Means one, if there are number of threads are available, for 10 threads are available. So what is the distance? So it is an axial distance between 1 and 2, okay, and it is again similar distance 2 to 3, then 3 to 4, 4 to 5, and so on. Means one point to another point between adjacent tooth of worm. So these are known as axial pitch. And axial pitch of worm is equal to your circular pitch of matting worm gear, or we have already discussed this fundamental in helical gear, PA and PC. So PC is here circular pitch and PA is your axial pitch. Both are equal mathematically. Second point is lead. So what is the lead? It is distance, measure distance, or you can say that it is a linear distance through which a point on a threads move ahead in one revolution of worm. If what will happen, if worm will take one revolution, so this is known as lead. Okay, so for single start, for single revolution, you can say that lead is equal to axial pitch. But in double start, in three start, it may be changed. Or you can say that for multiple start thread, lead is equal to the axial pitch and number of starts. So it is denoted by small l, and this is equal to PA into N. N is here number of starts. So again, it will come in your mind, what is start? Start is on what, in one revolution, how many times of worm will revolve, or it will take revolution. So these are known as number of starts. So here P is axial pitch, N is equal to number of starts. And what is the lead angle? So it is a, you can see here in diagram, right? It is angle between tangent to the thread. Here you can see that here is one tangent is drawn to the thread helix on pitch cylinder and plane normal to the axis of worm. Means tangent and perpendicular, if we will draw a normal or perpendicular line, so angle between these two are known as lead angle. And next is your normal pitch. So what will be normal pitch? It is the distance measured along normal to the threads, means at some angle to the threads between two corresponding points on two adjacent threads. And mathematically, it is given by Pn is equal to Pa into cos of lambda. So lambda is here your lead angle. Next is your helix angle. So what is the helix angle? It is the angle between the tangent to the thread of helix on pitch cylinder and axis of worm. So here you can say that alpha w is here helix angle. So it is an angle between tangent which is drawn to the thread helix and axis of worm. So it is denoted by alpha w. And worm gear, worm helix angle is complement of worm lead angle. So you can see here lead angle plus helix angle is equal to 90 degrees. So lead angle and helix angle are complement to each other. Next is velocity ratio. So velocity ratio, again it is a RPM of gear, RPM of worm divided by RPM on gear. And this is also given by Tz by N. So here Tz is number of teeth on gear divided by N. So what is N indicates? N indicates your number of starts. So by using this, you can find out velocity ratio. Next is pitch circle diameter. So you can see here pitch circle diameter of the worm in terms of center distance is given by, so what is the center distance? Center distance is center to center distance. So center distance from gear to center distance of your worm. So it is known as X, and it is noted by X. You can see here in this figure. So pitch circle diameter or worm is given, this is the standard formula, X ki power 0.875 divided by 1.416. Okay, and here X is equal to dW plus dz by 2. So dW indicates your diameter for the wheel, diameter for worm, and dz indicates for diameter for gear. And PA is here axial pitch, PC circular pitch, we have already discussed that. And pitch circle diameter of worm may be taken as dW is equal to 3 times of circular pitch. Okay, so this is the relation. If any data is missing, so by using this relation, you can find this value. Now, next point is, what are the forces act in worm gear during your operation or during any functioning of your gear? So worm gear is used for transmitting power. So forces may be act on worm, and these forces are similar to your power screw. We have already seen that worm is act like a screw mechanism. It is just behaving like a screw mechanism. So your forces will be also act just like your power screw. Okay, and if you can say that forces on worm gear are equal in magnitude to that of worm, means worm gear and on worm forces are equal but in opposite direction. So you can see here WR, WA. So WA is indicating your axial load, WR is indicating your radial load. Okay, WT is similar to the axial, or you can say that tangential load. So here you can see in diagram. Next is your thermal rating of worm gear. This is also very important, because when we use gear, so there may be power may be dissipated due to the temperature of lubricant which is used inside of your bearing, or you can say that there may be loss of power due to the friction and any other reason. Okay, so heat generation due to the work lost, what will happen if some power will be dissipated without using of, so that is your loss of power. So you can see that the quantity of heat generated is given by power lost in friction in watts. Okay, what is the generation? This is equal to power loss in friction. So what will happen due to the friction? Power may be wastage. Okay, so this is equal to P into 1 minus 1 minus your efficiency. So here P is indicating power and it is equal to efficiency of warm gear. So this is the loss of power, or you can say that heat generation. Next is your heat generated. What amount of heat may be generated inside of system? It may be dissipated through the lubricating oil to the gearbox housing, and then from there it may be dissipated to the atmosphere. So the heat dissipation capacity depends on some factor. So what are these factor? So these are the factor. First is area of housing. Second one is your temperature difference between housing surface and surrounding. And third one is your conductivity of your material. So what is the conductivity of material? So it is denoted by K. Okay, so what is the mathematical formula when temperature difference is there? So what is the heat amount of heat may be dissipated? So QD is equal to A into T2 minus T1 into K. Or you can say that Q is equal to simply fundamental DT multiplied by area multiplied by K. So this is your heat dissipation equation and this is your standard equation. So by using these two equations, heat generation is given by P into 1 minus eta, okay, and heat dissipation is given by A into T2 minus T1 into K. So by equating these two equations, you can find out temperature difference. So this is known as thermal rating of warm gear. If these are these fundamental is not given, these parameters are not given, so what will happen? So there is again one standard equation is given between permissible input power, or you can say that power transmission, between your velocity ratio and center distance of two gears, warm and warm gear. So from AGMA, this is the standard equation given by when gears speed up to 2000 RPM. So you can find out by using this relation, power is equal to 3650x multiplied by x is here center to center distance. So x ki power 1.7 divided by velocity ratio plus 5. So here x is center distance in meters, P is equal to power in kilowatt, and VR is your velocity ratio. So if these parameters will not given, if K is not given, temperature is not given, area is not given, conductivity is not given, so what will, so you can find out unknown parameters by using this equation, or you can directly find out power from thermal point of view. Okay, so you can use this equation as a standard equation. Thank you.